What can fans expect from the new series?
Like I keep saying, you can expect bigger and better from this series. The scripts have been bigger and better. I think everyone's commitment has been bigger and better. I think we've been really spurred on by the sort of real fight to get it back onto any kinds of screens. And it's fantastic. We've got Amazon behind us, and it's great that BBC came behind us. And we're all really thrilled to be here. And what an event. I mean, when do you have a TV series that opens like this? Ever. I've never experienced it, so it's a first for me. The new series starts 4 years after the second series, which really allows the storytelling to have the characters have evolved in this interim where we've not seen them. In terms of Long Susan, she has gone from being a brothel madam to being somebody who has decided to refuse to be controlled by any man. She's become an entrepreneur of Whitechapel, one of the most influential entrepreneurs in Whitechapel, in terms of financially, politically, socially, and she now is running an organisation that is committed to helping better the lives of the people in Whitechapel. So for her, it's a real turnaround. She's become an incredibly powerful figure in our society of Ripper Street. I mean, I've been so lucky with the scripts. They've been fantastic, and the writers have really allowed Long Susan to go on an incredible journey. So it's definitely that, but it's also the fact that I love this story, and I love the people involved in making it, and I love the characters, and I love everything about Ripper Street. We were joking today, and we were saying it's a bit like being back at school, you know, after a really boring summer holiday at home. This is a telly family, you know, we're all really close, we have such a good time together, we have such a giggle working together and such a giggle hanging out together, so it's been a lot of fun today. I think, absolutely, Amazon have been incredible in the way that they have sort of championed this series, and also our producers who really fought to get the deal with Amazon to go ahead, and it's exciting because it's the first deal of its kind in the UK, which is amazing, and that's really thrilling, and it's a really exciting thing to be a part of. And I think, yes, they allowed Richard Warlow, the creator of Ripper Street, and also our other main writer, Toby Finney, to really go to town and do what they needed to do, and the other writers to do what they felt was right for this series. But what I think is fantastic as well is that they've kept the sort of thread of Ripper Street very continuous. So it doesn't feel like all of a sudden we're telling a very different story to what we were telling before. It feels like we are part of the same world that we were in before, which is wonderful, and I think that's a sign of very good producing. What I do think is exciting in the fact that Amazon viewers will get to see a much longer cut is that they will get to have a different kind of story than I think you can tell in a shorter cut. They'll get to get more scenes and more in-depth information about characters, and they'll get to go on more kind of involved journeys with the characters, which I'm very excited for them. Reed and Drake have gone through huge changes. Reed, we find him a sort of almost a bit of a broken man, I think. He's become absolutely obsessed with detective work, has become absolutely obsessed with scientific methods for finding and tracking potential suspects. And it sort of absorbed his entire world. It's like he has lost everything else. He's lost his wife, he's lost his child. And Drake has... He's left, like Rose has left Whitechapel. But of course, Whitechapel is their home, so they come back. And like you find with all of these characters, there's something about Whitechapel that just brings them all back to its streets. They cannot leave Whitechapel no matter how hard they try.